The public service minister said that a letter was sent on March 6, 2019, requesting all public servants be given time off to attend a meeting called by the CSA on March 11th. The letter, Dr. Ubaldus Raymond says, was received on March 8th and a response was sent to the CSA.
What was shocking was that we had a notice, the CSA had sent out a notice to its members of that said meeting for March 11th before they actually got a response from the public service, which goes to say that the letter that was sent to the public service was almost of none effect, so to speak, because the CSA had already informed the members prior to that response from the public service that they will be meeting on March 11th. I believe that if we are dialoguing, the dialogue is supposed to be done in good faith.
Following Monday's meeting, the CSA called on government to meet at the soonest so that the negotiations could come to an amicable close. According to Dr. Raymond, the business of the country was not affected. However, the defiant public servants remained off the job for a second day Tuesday.
It's almost, it's actually a time when you can actually paralyze the services of government. Luckily, there were some members of public officers who saw beyond just being a member of the CSA, but a public officer providing service to the public, and they continued doing that on Monday morning. And I can safely say that that we were, government services were not interrupted at any of the government ministries or departments.
According to Dr. Raymond, the government negotiating team will be meeting very soon with both the Trade Union Federation and the CSA to discuss the way forward. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.